The objective of this video is to show you how to perform the self-test and the leakage test on the Zeus family anesthesia devices.
The self-test should be performed every 24 hours. To do so, while in the standby display, you press the device test button. You will be automatically guided to the self-test. In the display, you will see the test result, but first you will have to verify on the checklist. Here, you will verify all the different components around the anesthesia device. The first group of components to verify are the ones related to the supplies and safety. In the first place, we have to make sure that there is power supply feeding the anesthesia device. We can verify this by the two small LEDs in the lower part of the display. This means that the anesthesia device is sourced by electricity and the internal backup battery, it is plugged and it is being charged. The second component to verify is the central gas supply. We have to make sure that the hoses are connected to the central supply, and we can also verify through the small LEDs that the gases are present. The third component are the gas cylinders. Here in this case, we have to go to the back of the anesthesia device and verify on the cylinders. In this case, we do not have backup cylinders, and you can verify also that the LEDs are not lit. The next component is the emergency breathing bag. Always make sure that an external emergency resuscitator is available for you. The next component to verify is the oxygen flush. We have to press it and we have to make sure that this flow is going into the manual breathing bag. The next component to verify is the oxygen emergency safety valve. Here again, we have to press the component and we have to set it to the maximum flow of oxygen and verify that the manual breathing bag gets filled again. And then we return it to its original place. The next group of components to verify are the ones related to the breathing system. In first place, we have to make sure that the anesthetic gas scavenging system is connected and it is functioning. You verify that visually inspecting the back of the anesthesia device. The next element to verify is the breathing hose system. Make sure that these are tightly connected and in the right port, including the manual breathing bag. The next element to verify is the APL valve. This should be set in the manual position in the level of 20. The next element to verify is the soda lime canister. You can verify on the condition, but the color change on the soda lime. The next group of components to verify are the ones related to the suction unit and the white piece. First, you have to check on the endotracheal suction. You have to make sure that the container is not filled, that the suctioning filter has been exchanged, and that the unit is functional. To do so, you take the hose in your tip and you take it to the maximum level. Then you occlude the tip and you have to make sure that you have flow and suctioning on the tip. The next element to verify, in case you have it, is the microbial filters. You have to make sure that a new filter is in place. The following element to verify is the white piece. You have to make sure that a mechanical filter with HME is in place. And that it is connected to the self-test port. The next element to verify is the gas measurement sample line. This should be connected to the filter and to the water trap. The next element to verify are the water traps, making sure that they are empty and that they are positioned in place. After finalizing with all the verification of components detailed on the checklist, we can start with the self-test after verifying the three final elements. First, we have to make sure that we plug the white piece into the self-test adapter. Second, that the sample line is connected. And third, that the APL valve is set to 20. And now we can start and confirm. Once the self-test has finalized, you will immediately see the green flag highlighting that the self-test has been completed and the device is fully operable. If you need to verify on the details of the performed self-test, you can close the dialog and you come to the device test. Here, you can see on the tab Test Results all the different internal components that have been tested. Here again, you will see the color green in all the different elements, meaning that all of them have passed the test and the device is fully operable. Keep in mind that if the color that you get at the end of the self-test is yellow, that means that the device is partially functional because there are one or more components which are not operational, but those are not critical and you will be able to start the case. In the case the self-test is displayed in color red, that is because one or more components in the test have failed and the device is not functional. In this case, you cannot start the case. The second test that you can perform is the leak test. This one should be performed between patients once you have exchanged the breathing hose system or the soda lime canister or the water trap. Here you press on the leak test button and you will be displayed with the same checklist that we just reviewed for the self-test. Supply and safety group of components to verify, breathing system components to verify, suction and white piece systems to verify. Once you have gone through the complete checklist, you just press a star to continue with the leakage test. Now that the leak test has finalized, again, you will see the green flag indicating that the device is fully operational. The last test that you can perform on the Zeus family devices is the leakage assistant. For that, you go to the device test button and you will have the leakage assistant button directly in the third position. The leakage assistant is to support you identifying leakages on the system. You will see on the display a continuous reading on the pressure built on the system and a continuous reading on the level of leakage on the system. If the level of leakage is too high, you will see the number in color red. If it is, as in this case, an acceptable level of leakage, you will see the number in color blue. For demonstration purpose, I will create a leakage on the system by unplugging the lower lock port with the sample line. As you can see in the case of a leakage, the highlighted number is in color red. And you also have a recommended system to verify in the false section. We now have identified and corrected the leakage and have an acceptable level of leakage. To finalize the leakage assistant, we just press on cancel button and confirm using the rotary knob.